Hello everyone, welcome to Arpita Sharma classes. I am Arpita Sharma, your educator, and today we are going to understand in detail with the help of prelims based MCQs the economic survey of 2020. Aap sabhi ka swagat hai Arpita Sharma classes mein. Aaj hum prelims based kuch MCQs ki madad se बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट फैक्ट्स आज के जो इकोनॉमिक सर्वे 2020 का इकोनॉमिक सर्वे है, करंट ईयर का जो इकोनॉमिक सर्वे है, उसके डिटेल्स को समझेंगे, फैक्ट्स को समझेंगे विद प्रॉपर एक्सप्लेनेशन एंड विद द सपोर्ट ऑफ प्रीलिम्स बेस्ड एमसीक्यूज. सो द पीडीएफ विल बी अपलोडेड ऑन द टेलीग्राम चैनल, राइट. लेट्स स्टार्ट डिकोडिंग द इकोनॉमिक सर्वे इन अ वेरी फन वे. एक बहुत ही फन और एक्सप्लेनेटरी वे में हम इकोनॉमिक सर्वे को समझने जा रहे हैं, राइट. आई डोंट वॉन्ट एनी वन ऑफ यू टू क्रैम द डिटेल्स अबाउट द इकोनॉमिक सर्वे, द डेटा प्रेजेंट इन द इकोनॉमिक सर्वे. मैं नहीं चाहती हूं आप में से कोई भी रट्टाबाजी करे यहां पर. वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड, येस, सर्टन इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट्स एंड फिगर्स वी हैव टू क्रैम इट, बट वी विल क्रैम इट विद प्रॉपर एक्सप्लेनेशन एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग. कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट्स और फिगर्स तो हमें क्रैम करना ही पड़ेगा, रट्टा तो एक तरीके से कुछ ना कुछ हमें लगाना ही पड़ेगा, बट हम ये मेक श्योर करेंगे कि उस रट्टेबाजी में ना हमारी अंडरस्टैंडिंग पीछे ना छूट जाए. ओके, सो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न मेमोराइज फैक्ट्स एंड फिगर्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग प्रॉपर एक्सप्लेनेशन. As we all know, the theme of Economic Survey 2020 is what? It is to enable markets, promote pro-business policies and strengthen trust in the economy. Now, I am going to underline certain words. You also have to underline the same. First, enable markets, promote pro-business policies and strengthen trust. These three points we are going to understand each one of them in the upcoming स्लाइड्स. आने वाली स्लाइड्स में हम इनको समझने वाले हैं, राइट. सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दी थीम. नाउ द इकोनॉमिक सर्वे हैज फोकस्ड ऑन वेल्थ क्रिएशन, नॉट जनरेशन, क्रिएशन. वेल्थ क्रिएशन पे फोकस किया है इस बार के इकोनॉमिक सर्वे ने. सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस एज वेल फॉर योर अपकमिंग प्रीलिम्स. इकोनॉमिक सर्वे 2020 इज अ डॉक्यूमेंट विच कंप्राइजेज ऑफ टू वॉल्यूम्स, वॉल्यूम 1 एंड वॉल्यूम 2. दो वॉल्यूम्स होते हैं. Economic survey is prepared by Department of Economic Affairs under whose guidance? Under the guidance of Chief Economic Advisor. Currently it is Krishnamurthy V. Subramaniam. Okay, तो जो हमारा economic survey है उसको कौन तैयार करता है? Department of Economic Affairs. And it is prepared under the guidance of Chief Economic Advisor. When we talk about Department of Economic Affairs, it comes under which ministry? Tell me in the comment section. कमेंट सेक्शन में जरा बताओ मुझे. डिपार्टमेंट जो है, ये तो डिपार्टमेंट की बात हो गई, कौन सी मिनिस्ट्री के अंडर आता है? दिस डिपार्टमेंट कम्स अंडर विच मिनिस्ट्री? टेल मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन, फटाफट से, यू हैव ओनली 2 सेकंड्स. इट कम्स अंडर मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस, वित्त मंत्रालय के अंदर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इकोनॉमिक अफेयर्स आता है, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस. मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस हैज 5 डिपार्टमेंट्स. राइट इट डाउन, इसको लिख लो, भूल मत जाना, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर प्रीलिम्स. मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस हैज 5 डिपार्टमेंट्स. Department of Expenditure, Department of Economic Affairs, Department of Financial Services, Department of Revenue and Department of Investment and Public Asset Management. They can ask you in the prelims because economic survey and budget has been released now. So they will ask questions this time from Ministry of Finance. Okay, क्योंकि ये budget release हुआ है तो Ministry of Finance में से question जरूर आएगा. तो इसके 5 departments हैं. They will give you the name of 4-5 departments, then they will ask you which of these departments fall under Ministry of Finance. 4-5 department का नाम दे देंगे, फिर पूछेंगे कौन से इनमें से कौन सा department Ministry of Finance के अंदर आता है. So it's Department of Expenditure, Financial Service, Economic Affairs, Expenditure and Revenue, दोनों भाई बहन है. Okay, both of them are brother and sister. So expenditure, where there is expenditure, there is revenue. Financial Service, Economic Affairs and Investment and Public Asset Management. All right, so Department of Economic Affairs will come under Ministry of Finance. Clear? Itta sabko clear ho gaya? This much you all have memorized, understood? The survey maintains an optimistic stance. Ab is survey mein na positivity jhalki hai is bar, right? Regarding the Indian economy. So there are hopes which have been, you can say, expressed through this Economic Survey 2020. The survey suggests framework to enable ethical wealth creation. I told you about wealth creation, right? Survey the framework which has been shown up or which has been recommended by the survey is of wealth creation, and that too ethical wealth creation. Matlab ethical ways se hum wealth create karenge. Through ethical ways only we are going to create wealth in India, and it will help India become a $5 trillion economy by 2025. Remember the target year. Target year yaad rakhna, this is very important for your prelims. Okay, clear everyone? Now also over here I told you about pro business policies, enable market samajh aa gaya, pro business policies maine aapko bataya tha. So what is pro business and what is pro crony? Pro business kya hota hai aur pro crony kya hota hai, let us understand that. When we talk about pro business means friendly, business friendly. Firms compete on a level playing field. That means on an equal level they are competing. Here in the picture also you can see there is healthy competition. Level playing field का मतलब होता है कि competition बहुत ही healthy है, सकारात्मक है, positive है. Resource allocation in the economy is also efficient, right? There is no mismanagement, there is no inequality, and citizens' welfare is maximized. Citizen के, जनता के welfare, जनता के भले के ऊपर focus किया जाता है pro-business economy में. Then what is pro-crony economy? Now here it is the opposite, complete opposite of pro-business economy. प्रो क्रोनी इकोनॉमी जो होती है प्रो बिजनेस इकोनॉमी की कंप्लीट उल्टी होती है, ऑपोजिट होती है. सम फर्म्स मे रिसीव प्रेफरेंशियल ट्रीटमेंट, रिसोर्स एलोकेशन इज नॉट एफिशिएंट, एंड देयर इज नो फोकस ऑन सिटीजंस वेलफेयर. सो सिटीजंस वेलफेयर इज नॉट मैक्सिमाइज्ड. क्लियर एवरीवन? इतना सबको क्लियर हो गया, इतना सबको समझ आ गया. नाउ दिस ईयर्स इकोनॉमिक सर्वे brought about 10 important ideas. इस बार के economic survey ने 10 ideas पे काम किया है, 10 ideas को forefront में रखा है. You have to memorize all these 10 new ideas. In prelims, what UPSC can do is they will give you the list of certain ideas, then they will ask you which of these ideas were included in economic survey 2019-20. आपसे करेंगे क्या UPSC में कि prelims में आपको कुछ ideas का list दे देंगे, 4-5 ideas की list देंगे, और फिर बोलेंगे इनमें से कौन से ideas जो हैं वो economic survey 2019-20 में आए ही नहीं हैं. So you have to remember, the first idea is wealth creation, which we all know. The main focus was only on wealth creation. Main focus is wealth creation pe hai. Second, enabling market, I told you over here, enable market, right? So second idea is enable market, market enable wealth creation. Then over here we talked about trust. So the third idea is trust is a public good that increase with use. ट्रस्ट एक तरीके का सामूहिक वस्तु है. जितना ज्यादा आप इसका जितना ज्यादा यूज करोगे उतना ज्यादा ही बढ़ेगा. फोर्थ, ग्रास रूट एंटरप्रेन्योर्स क्रिएट वेल्थ इन देयर डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स. हर रूट ग्रास रूट लेवल इंप्रूवमेंट, राइट? तो इसमें आप कह सकते हो कि ग्रास रूट लेवल वेल्थ क्रिएशन हो रही है, जो कि ग्रास रूट लेवल एंटरप्रेन्योर्स करेंगे थ्रू वेरियस स्टार्टअप्स. एंड फोर्थ इज प्रो बिजनेस पॉलिसीज. I told you what is pro business already. I told you what is pro crony. We are going to follow pro business policies. अगर आपको difference नहीं पता होता तो आप confused हो जाते, right? So that is why we have to understand the difference in order to better understand what are these policies. Pro business policies give equal opportunity. So memorized, wealth creation, market enable, trust, startups, grassroots entrepreneurs, they are creating wealth in their districts, and pro business policies. Then fifth idea is remove anachronistic government interventions. So government monopoly or government domination, negative domination should not be there. Sixth, job creation by assemble in India. Seventh, changes to EODB, ease of doing business. EODB means ease of doing business for India to rank up in top 50. अभी हम 63rd rank पे है ना, top 50 में लाना है खुद को, India को. Eighth idea, banking sector subscale compared to economy. And nine and very important and newest chapter added to economic survey 2019-20 is Thali economics, right? Thalinomics. ये बहुत ही important है. अब देखो, अब ये news में है, plus it is a very creative chapter which has been added, so you have to study it. We are going to study it, don't worry. Okay, now answer this question. इस question को फटाफट से answer करो. As per economic survey 1920, job opportunities and wealth creation can take place mainly through export, import, entreport, or none of the above. एंट्री पोर्ट मीन्स वट एवर यू आर इम्पोर्टिंग यू आर एक्सपोर्टिंग द सेम थिंग, जो आप इम्पोर्ट कर रहे हो उसी चीज को एक्सपोर्ट कर रहे हो ज्यादा प्राइस पर, तो वो एंट्री पोर्ट हो जाता है. इनमें से कौन से ऑप्शन है जो जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज और वेल्थ क्रिएशन पे फोकस करेंगे? इट इज एक्सपोर्ट्स. ओके, रिमेंबर दीज टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चन आर कमिंग इन प्रिलिम्स, इसलिए याद रखना. नाउ नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट इन दिस ईयर्स इकोनॉमिक सर्वे, India's rank in the creation of new firms, entrepreneurship, it is third. Remember the rank. India is third in the number of new firms which have been created. जितने भी नए firms create किए हैं, India की ranking उसमें third है. As per economic survey 2019-20, it takes 18 days to set up a business in India. अगर भारत में आपको business set up करना है, 18 दिन लगते हैं. But do not just get very happy. Right? It is, you know, huge number. In New Zealand, it takes only half a day. New Zealand में आधा दिन में business set up कर सकते हो. India में फिर भी 18 दिन लग रहे हैं. तो ये कोई number बहुत अच्छा नहीं है. ठीक है? This shows the ease of doing business. Now, this is a snapshot of Indian economy. PIB ने ये generate किया है. This every sector, every area has been shown. Right? One by one, we are going to study these sectors. So, as you can see in this snapshot, fiscal deficit, foreign exchange reserves, current account balance, what is the current number that has been displayed, right? Inflation, as you can see, the CPI is now at 4.1. So let us study all these through prelims MCQ based format. Now question number one. The economic survey projected CPI, CPI is consumer price index, in 2019-20, that is the current year. The economic survey projected CPI. Now look over here. We are talking about inflation. Consumer price index kahan project kiya hai? Just look at this. Where is it projected? In the current year, in percentage, it is 4.1. So correct answer is A, 4.1%. RBI, वैसे, you know, if you will look at this particular figure, the inflation is under control. Why? Because as per RBI's projection, it should be within 2-6%, and it is 4.1%, so it's under control. Okay. Now the next question, the economic survey projected current account balance in 2019-20 as, current account balance means the export minus import, the difference between export import. It can either be a deficit situation or a surplus situation. Ab current account situation jo hai wo deficit ho sakti hai aur wo surplus bhi ho sakti hai. Right now, is it minus 2.1, minus 1.5, minus means deficit, 2.1 or 1.5. Over here, current account balance, it is 1.5. August se September to April se September 2019 ka data dikhaya gaya hai survey mein. In this survey, the data between April to September 2019 has been shown. So it is 1.5, it is not minus, that means it is a surplus. Surplus ho gaya hai, 1.5. You have to remember these figures, okay? For your prelims. Ye figures aapko yaad rakhni hi padengi. Plus for your GS paper 3 also. Aapko yaad rakhna padega. You can mention these figures. It will enhance your, answer. Plus also will fetch you bonus marks. Okay? Now next question. Consider the following statements with respect to forex reserves. First, in 2019-20, India achieved highest ever forex reserves. Second, forex reserve has been uniformly increasing in last 5 years. These types of questions are time and again being asked by UPSC. Aise question bar bar UPSC puchta hai. Uniformly, extreme words. These are extreme words. Okay. So here intelligent guess can also be applicable. So over here you can see 2019-20 India achieved highest ever forex reserve. Idhar dekh sakte ho. It is 46.12. Yes, it is true. Statement number one is correct. Forex reserve means the foreign currency is gold, etc. kept with RBI. Forex reserve has been uniformly increasing in last 5 years. Let us see. This is the data of 1, 2, 3, 4. Last 4 years, right? It was in 16-17, it was 370. Then in 17-18, it was 425. Then it decreased to 413. So it has not been uniformly increasing. क्योंकि बढ़ रहा है घट रहा है तो यूनिफॉर्म इंक्रीमेंट नहीं है. स्टेटमेंट टू विल बी रॉन्ग. करेक्ट आंसर विल बी ए. ओके, Next question, consider the following statements with respect to growth of world economy. Again, very important topic which has been highlighted in the survey. Survey में बहुत ही अच्छे से इस topic को graph way में represent किया गया है. First, there will be decline in growth rate of world economy. Second, there will be uplift in the or increment in the growth rate of EMDE, that is emerging market and developing economies. Example are India, China, etc. So the correct answer will be, there will be decline in growth rate of world economy. This is world economy and yes, growth rate, there is a decline. Idhar dekh sakte ho na, ye decline dekhne ko mil raha hai na. First statement is true. Second, there will be uplift or increment in the growth rate of EMDE. No, it is also declining. Okay, so second statement is wrong. Okay, correct answer will be A. Now the next question, which Department of Finance Ministry releases economic survey? We studied this, humne abhi abhi just padha hai, batao jaldi se in the comment section, patafat. Tell me, isme se expenditure, revenue, financial service, economic affairs, kaun sa department release karta hai survey and budget? Which department releases survey and budget? It is D, economic affairs. Okay, it is D, economic affairs. Next question, consider the following statements with respect to economic survey. One, government is constitutionally mandated, obligated to bring economic survey. Second, government may or may not accept the findings of economic survey. So, which statement is correct? Kaun si statement correct hai, jaldi se batao. Kaun sa option sahi hai, fatafat batao. The correct option is A, which is correct, or B, which is correct, or C, or D. Tell me in the comment section. Correct option is B. First statement is wrong. Why? Because government is not constitutionally mandated. Government koi constitutionally mandated nahi hoti hai ki unhe economic survey lana hi lana hai. This is not true. Okay? So statement 2 is correct. Next question. In economic survey 2019-20, India's aspiration to become a $5 trillion economy depends critically on A, invisible hand, B, great hand, C, twisted hand, D, visible hand. Now let us apply an intelligent guess over here. अब यहाँ पर अगर आपको direct answer नहीं आता तो intelligent guess apply करने की कोशिश करते हैं. Look at option C, twisted hand. It can never be correct. ये गलत सही हो ही नहीं सकता. हाथ मरोड़ कर थोड़ी हमें एक 5 ट्रिलियन इकोनॉमी, 5 ट्रिलियन डॉलर इकोनॉमी का सपना यू नो पूरा करना पड़ेगा. दिस इज रॉन्ग. ग्रेट हैंड, देयर इज, इफ यू हैव स्टडीड बेसिक इकोनॉमिक्स ऑफ क्लास 11 12th, यू विल नो देयर इज नथिंग यू नो लाइक अ ग्रेट हैंड. अगर आपने 11वीं 12वीं की इकोनॉमिक्स या 9th 10th क्लास में भी इकोनॉमिक्स ढंग से पढ़ी है, सीरियसली पढ़ी थी या अभी खत्म करी है एनसीईआरटी, तो आपको पता होगा ग्रेट हैंड जैसा कॉन्सेप्ट तो होगा ही नहीं. Now, invisible and visible hand. So, the correct answer is invisible hand, because if you have studied economics of class 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, NCERT, you must have come across this term invisible hand. Now, the next question is, correct answer is over here, A, okay? Next question is, the invisible hand that economic survey 2019-20 mentioned has been taken from किसने इनविजिबल हैंड का कॉन्सेप्ट सामने रखा था? व्हाट इज इनविजिबल हैंड? द अनऑब्जर्व्ड मार्केट फोर्सेस ऑफ डिमांड एंड सप्लाई. डिमांड सप्लाई जो मार्केट फोर्सेस हैं उन्हें ही इनविजिबल हैंड बोलते हैं, राइट? सो दिस कॉन्सेप्ट वाज कॉइंड बाय रिचर्ड टेलर और अभिजीत बैनर्जी और एडम स्मिथ और जे एम कीन्स. नाउ अभिजीत बैनर्जी, इफ यू अप्लाई इंटेलिजेंट गेस, दिस विल बी द इनकरेक्ट ऑप्शन, बिकॉज ये तो अभी अभी आए हैं न्यूज में. और इनविजिबल हैंड का कॉन्सेप्ट हम एनसीईआरटी के टाइम से पढ़ रहे हैं, अपने स्कूल टाइम से पढ़ रहे हैं. अभिजीत बैनर्जी इज अ रॉन्ग ऑप्शन. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ दिस नेम हैज बीन इन न्यूज रिसेंटली, बट इनविजिबल हैंड कॉन्सेप्ट वाज इन न्यूज सिंस वी वर इन क्लास 10th, 11th, 12th, राइट? रिचर्ड टेलर, दिस इज ऑल्सो रॉन्ग. व्हाई? बिकॉज इफ यू हैव स्टडीड 2018-19 इकोनॉमिक सर्वे, यू मस्ट हैव यू नो कम अक्रॉस द टर्म नज थ्योरी, which was used in the economic survey of 1819. It was proposed by Richard Thaler. So it is also wrong. भाई, Richard Thaler की जो nudge theory थी, वो हमने economic survey 2018-19 में देखी थी. तो ये तो गलत हो गया। जे एम कीन्स, ही इज नोन एज द फादर ऑफ मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स, बट दिस ऑप्शन इज ऑल्सो रॉन्ग। करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज सी, एडम स्मिथ। He is known as the father of economics, and in 1776, in his book named Wealth of Nation, this term was used. Adam Smith, जिनको economics, father of economics कहते हैं, 1776 में इनकी किताब आई थी Wealth of Nation, जिसमें invisible hand, demand supply के बारे में इन्होंने बात की थी. Now, what is consumer price index? Let us understand that also, कि consumer price index क्या है. It is a measure that examines the weighted average of price of a basket of consumer goods and services like transportation, food, medical care, etc. Okay, so there are 8 major groups of consumer price index. You have to remember all the 8 major groups. First is housing. Second is apparel, that is the clothes. Transportation, education and communication, other goods and services, recreation, that is gymming and yoga, etc. Medical care, food and beverages. Very easy to remember. First is housing. आप घर में रह रहे हो ना, तो housing. Second, you are taking education. You are taking classes from me. So education and communication. Then you are either using, doing meditation or yoga or attending a gym. So third will be recreation. Okay. Then fourth will be हम कभी-कभी दवाई वगैरह भी खरीदते हैं. We sometimes also purchase medicines, so medical care. Then fifth, cold drink वगैरह भी पीते हो, बाहर का खाना भी खाते हो, चाय वगैरह भी पीते हो, so food and beverages. Sixth, you wear clothes, so apparel. Then you travel also, so transportation. Okay, and eighth, other goods and services, बाकी की चीजें. Alright, so remember these 8 major groups of consumer price index. Now the next question. What is the color of economic survey 2019 and 20? Last time pink color tha na? Is time kya color hai? Fatafat se batao. Is it purple, pink, lavender or blue? Look at over here. Look at it. Batao kaun sa color hai? It is lavender. Okay. If in prelims, you know, it looks like purple only. It's lightish purplish. Okay. Now, if in prelims, the lavender option is not there and the options are purple, pink, blue or black, then you can click tick on purple. Agar lavender option nahi diya jata prelims, vaise to diya jayega, to aap purple pe click karna, but vaise lavender hai, yaad rakhna. What is the overarching theme of economic survey 2019-20? This we studied in the first slide itself. A, remove poverty. B, tackle inflation. C, wealth creation. Or D, uplifting social sectors. Correct option is C, wealth creation. Now answer another question. The economic survey of 2019-20 has compared the trust to, we studied this in the first slide, private good, consumer good, public good or capital good. Let us go back to the first slide and then we'll answer this question. Trust in the economy. Trust दिख रहा है आपको? इधर word. We studied this word trust. Over here the 10 new ideas. इधर 10 new ideas पढ़े थे. Trust is a public good that increase with use. So trust is linked with which term? Public good. किस term से linked है ये word? Public good. Correct answer will be C. Next question, the economic survey projected agriculture growth in 2019 to 20, 1.5%, 3.5%, 2.8% or 4.9%. This we studied in yesterday's introductory economic survey class. जो कल की introductory economic survey class थी, उसमें अपने पढ़ा था ये. पटाफट से बताओ. As you can see in the picture, 2019-20, it is 2.8%. Okay? It has decrease hua hai. The economic survey projected industrial growth in 2019-20. Industrial growth batao fatafat se, looking at this chart. Is chart ki taraf dekho aur industrial good ke baare mein batao. Kya project kiya hai, kitna growth rate hoga? Yes, it is B, 2.5%. It has also decreased growth rate, isme bhi decrease kar raha hai. The economic survey projected service sector growth in 2019-20. Look at this map and answer the question. Is map ki taraf dekho, is chart ki taraf dekho aur answer karo. Correct answer is A, 6.9%. So it's also decreasing the growth rate in all the three sectors. Jo projection hai, wo decrease hua hai. The projection has decreased, okay? The economic survey projected GDP growth for fiscal year 2019-20, that is the current year, as 4%, 4.5%, 5% or 5.5%. Answer the question. For the year 2019-20, I am asking. Correct answer is C, 5%. Idhar dekho. 2019-20 ka dekhoge to 5% hai. And the economic survey projected GDP growth rate for fiscal year 2020-21 as 6 to 6.5%. So C is the correct answer in both cases. Now, what is the importance of economic survey? Let's understand. The economic survey discusses all the major government initiatives with explanations. So, if you want to frame good answers in GS paper 3, then you have to use phrases used in economic survey like invisible hand, trust, public good, pro-business, pro-crony. These are the important words used in economic survey which you can use in your GS paper 3 answers to enhance your answers and fetch bonus marks. The survey analyzes and gives reasons for many issues. Ab survey mein kya hota hai? Data to diya hota hai. In survey the data is presented, but why this is happening? Why the growth rate is so low? Why the growth rate has been increasing? So the explanation is also there in survey. Survey mein uska explanation bhi diya hota hai. The issues appraised in the economic survey and reforms suggested are often implemented by government in future initiatives. So this will be a good, you know, a good example of this can be direct benefit transfer. It was also suggested in economic surveys, which was also implemented by government. Economic survey mein kya hota hai ki jo Ministry of Finance hoti hai, wo issues to present karti hai. Kya initiatives hone chahiye, kya suggestions, reformations honi chahiye, wo bhi present karti hai. To government usko implement karti hai. Good phrases can be used from the survey, like good economics is a good politics, less government, maximum governance, twin balance sheet problem, Chakravyuh challenge. These terms are presented in economic survey, which you can use in your exam. Aap apne exam mein use kar sakte ho. Okay? And do not skip economic survey. Is class ko skip mat kar dena, please. Ye bahut important hai prelims ke liye. Theek hai? 18 to 20 marks you can easily fetch from economic survey and budget. But if you skip economic survey and budget na, by procrastinating or by, you know, not being serious or dedicated, then you will miss out the marks in the final cutoff list. Jo cutoff list niklegi, usme aap piche reh jaoge, right? Ek number matter karta hai. Economic survey is divided into two parts, volume 1 and volume 2. Volume 1 or volume 2 mein divided hai, aapko pata hi hai. Volume 1 deals with conceptual and analytical issues. But volume 2 deals with state of economy and sectors of economy. We are covering both things, right? Pro-business, pro-crony, ये जो terms है वो volume 1 में है. And बाकी की चीजें किस में है? जो sector-wise analysis है, वो volume 2 में है. Now, how to read economic survey? Read after a basic study. First, do a basic understanding. What is GDP? What is cause, you know, CPI? What is fiscal drag inflation? So, NCRTs, अगर आपने command करी हुई है economy की NCRTs पर, तो आप बहुत अच्छे से economic survey समझ सकते हो. If you do not have command over NCRTs, then it will be very tough to study economic survey. Read the preface thoroughly. The boxes and arguments presented in economic survey, that is also important from GS paper 3 and prelims perspective. And break it into small topics. How? I'll show you. You can look at this, right? So what I am doing over here is I have broken the important chapters or topics in economic survey like this in a flowchart manner. You can do the same. वैसे तो PDF will be available, but you can also, you know, try to make your own notes, your own PDFs, your like this. You can just, you know, divide the chapters of economic survey in flowcharts. इस तरीके से flowcharts के तरीके से आप chapters को divide कर सकते हो. अपनी understanding के way में उसको summarize कर सकते हो. You can summarize economic survey. Now let's start with Thalinomics, a very new and very creative, you know, chapter which has been added. Bahut hi badhiya interesting chapter hai Thalinomics jo add kiya gaya volume 1 mein. What is Thalinomics? It is the economics of plate of food in India. What is Thalinomics? Thalinomics kya hai? जो खाने की प्लेट है ना उसकी उसकी जो इकोनॉमिक्स है उसे हम थालीनॉमिक्स कहते हैं. थालीज विद रिस्पेक्ट टू वन डेज पे ऑफ अ वर्कर हैव इम्प्रूव ओवर टाइम एज पर द इकोनॉमिक सर्वे ऑफ 2020. इन अदर वर्ड्स यू कैन से दैट एन इंडिविजुअल हु वुड हैव स्पेंट अराउंड 70% ऑफ हिज और हर डेली वेज ऑन टू वेजिटेरियन थालीज फॉर अ हाउस होल्ड ऑफ फाइव इन 2006-07 इज एबल टू अफोर्ड द सेम नंबर ऑफ थालीज विद अराउंड 50% ऑफ हिज और हर डेली वेज इन 2019. सो दिस मीन्स अफोर्डेबिलिटी हैज इंप्रूव्ड हैज इंक्रीज्ड. पहले 2006-2007 में जो इंसान अपने वेज का डेली वेज का 70% खर्च कर देता था पांच लोगों के लिए दो वेजिटेरियन थालीज खरीदने में, अब वो 2019 में 50% ही स्पेंड करता है, खर्च करता है दो थालीज खरीदने में, राइट? तो इससे क्या है, अफोर्डेबिलिटी इंप्रूव हुई है वेजिटेरियन थालीज की. फॉर नॉन वेजिटेरियन थालीज इट हैज इंप्रूव बाय 18%, फॉर वेजिटेरियन थालीज इट हैज इंप्रूव बाय 29%. थाली मींस प्लेट ऑफ फूड. ओके, द थीम ऑफ इकोनॉमिक सर्वे इज वेल्थ क्रिएशन, प्रमोशन ऑफ प्रो बिजनेस पॉलिसी एंड स्ट्रेंथनिंग ऑफ ट्रस्ट इन पब्लिक गुड इन द इकोनॉमी. थालीनॉमिक्स मींस व्हाट अ प्लेटफुल ऑफ फूड वुड कॉस्ट अक्रॉस द कंट्री. एक प्लेट का जो खाना है कितना कितना महंगा पड़ेगा वो थालीनॉमिक्स में आता है. So the economic survey 2019-20 has used thalinomics, what a common person pays for a vegetarian or non-vegetarian thali. Okay? Now the thalinomics, the economics of plate of food in India, it is an attempt to quantify. Ye ek attempt hai. To what? To quantify what a common person pays for a thali, for a plate of food across India. Okay? This is owing to sharp downward trend in price of vegetables and dal in contrast to the previous trend of increasing prices. Economic survey says that food is not just an end in itself, but also an essential ingredient in the growth of human capital and therefore important for national wealth creation. Human capital here means, human capital matlab labor. Hum jo logo ko employ karte hain, our employees, those are human capital, right? So, availability of food is very important for growth of human capital. खाना नहीं मिलेगा तो human capital improve कैसे होगा? और अगर human capital improve होगा तो wealth creation भी होगा, right? ज़्यादा काम करेगा वो इंसान. So zero hunger has been agreed upon by nations of the world as a SDG. Zero hunger को sustainable development goal भी बनाया देशों ने, right? Zero hunger has been made a sustainable development goal also by nations. The survey states that across India and also the four regions, North, South, East and West, it is found that the absolute price of vegetarian thali have decreased significantly. Okay? Now, there have been many new firms created in the country. Tell me India's rank in the new firm creations. We discussed it. Jaldi se batao. Let us see how many of you are memorizing things in the class only. Dekhte aap mein se kitne bachche class mein achche se memorize kar pa rahe ho. Ya kitne bachche so rahe ho. What is India's ranking in the new firm creation? New firm creation में भारत की ranking क्या है? फटाफट बताओ. It is third. Okay, very good. So in the formal sector, there has been a 12.2% cumulative annual growth rate of new firms compared to 3.8% in 2006-14. About 12.4 lakh new firms were created this year in the year 2018. Okay. और वहीं अगर 2014 में देखोगे तो 70,000 फर्म्स ही बनी थी. 80% इंप्रूवमेंट देखने को मिला है. नाउ अबाउट प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना ग्रामीण, नंबर ऑफ हाउसेस कंप्लीटेड इन अ ईयर हैव बीन यू नो क्वाड्रुपल्ड, फोर टाइम्स इंक्रीज हुए नंबर ऑफ हाउसेस इस प्रोग्राम के तहत, स्कीम के तहत. ग्रॉस डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्ट ऑफ यूएसडी 5 ट्रिलियन बाय 2024, इंडिया नीड्स टू स्पेंड अबाउट 1.4 ट्रिलियन यूएस डॉलर, दैट इज रुपीज 1 लाख करोड़ ओवर these years on infrastructure, so that lack of infrastructure does not become an impediment, a problem to the growth of economy. Bharat ko abhi 2024 tak 100 lakh crore add infrastructure mein invest karne padenge. Then the livestock, it has emerged as an important secondary source of income. Underline this, secondary source of income, hamare country mein important secondary source of income livestock ban gayi hai, cattle rearing ban gaya hai rural families ke liye. There is a need to bring in a distinction between hoarding and storage of food grains. This hoarding matlab इलीगली होल्ड करके रखना खाने को, ताकि जब उसका डिमांड बढ़े तो प्राइस इंक्रीज करके उसे मार्केट में भेज, सप्लाई कम हो, सप्लाई कम कर देंगे तो डिमांड बढ़ेगी, उससे क्या होगा, प्राइस अपने मन मुताबिक मांगेंगे, राइट? सो इट हैज टू बी अवॉइड, इट हैज टू बी, यू कैन से, यू नो, टेकन आउट ऑफ द इकोनॉमी, सो दैट फार्मर्स इनकम इज डबल्ड. देन वेन वी टॉक अबाउट ट्रीज एंड फॉरेस्ट कवर, स्टेट्स एंड यूनियन टेरिटरीज हैव शोन एन इंक्रीज इन फॉरेस्ट कवर. स्टेट्स लाइक कर्नाटका, जम्मू कश्मीर, आंध्र प्रदेश, दीज स्टेट्स हैव शोन इंक्रीज. स्टेट्स शोइंग दी लॉस ऑफ फॉरेस्ट कवर आर मेघालय, मणिपुर, मिजोरम एंड अरुणाचल प्रदेश. अंडरलाइन इट एंड राइट इट डाउन, इसको लिख लो, दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर प्रिलिम्स. आयुष्मान भारत हैज ऑल्सो सेटअप 28,005 हेल्थ एंड वेलनेस सेंटर्स एज ऑफ 14 जनवरी 2020. The out of pocket expenditure as on health as a percentage of total health expenditure has also reduced from 64.2 to 58.7%. When we talk about green bond market, what is green bond market? It is basically an instrument for mobilizing funds for green projects like wind power, solar power, biomass power. होता क्या है, बॉन्ड्स खरीदेंगे तो जो रेवेन्यू आएगा, जो इनकम आएगी, वो सोलर पावर, विंड पावर, ऐसे प्रोजेक्ट्स को फंड करने में लगाई जाएगी. ओके, इट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम जनरल बॉन्ड बिकॉज फंड रेज्ड फ्रॉम दिस बॉन्ड आर यूज्ड फॉर ग्रीन प्रोजेक्ट्स. तो इस बॉन्ड से जो फंड्स रेज होते हैं, वो फंड्स ग्रीन प्रोजेक्ट में, विंड हो गया, पावर प्रोजेक्ट, सोलर पावर प्रोजेक्ट, बायोमास पावर प्रोजेक्ट, उसमें इन्वेस्ट किए जाते हैं, लगाए जाते हैं. इंडिया हैज सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट इमर्जिंग ग्रीन बॉन्ड मार्केट आफ्टर चाइना. दिस फैक्ट इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर प्रिलिम्स. चाइना के बाद सेकेंड रैंक पे अगर कोई आता है लार्जेस्ट इमर्जिंग ग्रीन बॉन्ड मार्केट के, यू नो, लिस्ट में, वो इंडिया है. स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया हैज ऑल्सो एंटर्ड द ग्रीन बॉन्ड मार्केट विद $650 मिलियन सर्टिफाइड क्लाइमेट बॉन्ड. अंडरलाइन दिस, इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट, विच बैंक हैज एंटर्ड दिस मार्केट? स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया. ओके, then the transportation sector, if we talk about the transportation sector growth, there are two sectors, open sector and closed sector. Open sector is the roadways, closed sector is railways, where government monopoly is there. So when we compare these two sectors, road transportation sector has shown more growth as compared to railways since 1999 से ही अगर हम देखें तो जो रोड सेक्टर है, रोड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन सेक्टर है, उसमें ग्रोथ रेट रेलवे से कंपैरिजन में ज्यादा है. व्हाई? बिकॉज इट्स एन ओपन सेक्टर, रेलवे इज क्लोज सेक्टर. सो इनडायरेक्टली द सर्वे हैज सेड इट इज द टाइम, इट इज द राइट टाइम टू मेक रेलवेज एन ओपन सेक्टर. तो इकोनॉमिक सर्वे ने बहुत ही इनडायरेक्टली ये बात सामने रखी है कि रेलवेज को अब ओपन सेक्टर बनाने का समय आ गया है, क्योंकि ग्रोथ रेट कम है इसकी. देन इकोनॉमिक सर्वे टॉक्स अबाउट, फोकस इज ऑन नेशनल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर पाइपलाइन. Now, when we talk about national infrastructure pipeline, what is it? It will ensure that the infrastructure projects are adequately prepared and launched. The central and state governments would have equal share of 39% each in this national infrastructure pipeline. But the private sector would have 22% share, and it is expected to increase to 30% by the year 2025. So basically, each ministry and department would be responsible for monitoring projects through NIP. In order to make sure that timely and cost effectively completion is there, it will help in stepping up annual infrastructure investment to achieve GDP growth rate of $5 trillion by 2024-25. Okay, clear everyone? So this was all about the economic survey of 2020. ये आपके basic highlighted points थे economic survey 2020 के. I hope you all enjoyed it. The link is given below in the डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स टू परचेज द इकोनॉमिक सर्वे पीडीएफ. जो इकोनॉमिक सर्वे का ये जो क्लास पीडीएफ है, इसको परचेज करने का लिंक नीचे डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में दिया हुआ है. ऑल राइट, थैंक यू एंड हैव अ नाइस डे.